don't think. I mean, how many cameras are deployed now to cover a football game, a playoff game? They had 20 cameras?
Yeah.
They had, like, you know, two dudes with cell phones is what they had at that game. Look, that game.
Little camcorders.
That game and that play are the most famous football things, respectively, I think, of my lifetime. I know there's the catch, there's the drive. There's a lot of stuff. But that may be number one, even though it wasn't on NFL Films list. So, no, it didn't touch the ground from what we can see. And Derek Carr wouldn't have any other view that we don't have. And no, it's not effective trash talking, because no one even on the Steelers knows what the hell that was, because nobody now under 50 has any sense of history. So it doesn't make any difference. I'm impressed with Derek Carr that he would drop it like that. And it was so funny and timely when he said didn't touch the ground. That was very cool. Makes me like Derek Carr more. Doesn't matter in the least.
Yeah, what I like about it is it's going to fire up. It's really not going to fire up any current players on the Steelers. What it's going to do, it's going to fire up their fan base, and we know they have a great fan base. And next thing you know, Derek Carr is going to be on the ground a bunch, I think, on Sunday in Pittsburgh. But I'll tell you, one of my earliest memories of football is Franco Harris. We loved him because he was half Italian. That ball did not hit the ground. And back then, if you remember, Mike, the reason why Oakland was arguing that play was because back then, two offensive players could not touch the ball. It had to be deflected.
No.
So that's what they were complaining about.
Yes.
But that rivalry, if you go back to 75, you remember this. They're playing the AFC title game. George Atkinson on a clean play knocks Lynn Swann out of the game.
Yes.
Lynn Swann spends 2 days in the hospital. Think about concussion protocol. Ended up playing in the Super Bowl. The following season, George Atkinson knocks him out again. Lynn Swann concussion. This time it wasn't a legal hit. Forearm to the back of the head.
Well,
that's a great robbery.
The phrase criminal intent
is
meant to describe the Oakland Raiders secondary and the hits they laid on people.
That's
and
right.
Specifically to narrow that down to hitting Steelers receivers in
that's
the Hall
right.
of Fame. And look, as a kid, it seems like you always saw whenever the Raiders and Steelers played each other. There were only at one point 23 teams in the NFL, something like that. I thought it was an odd number. And those games are surreal. And
yep.
So you don't have any hitting like that. You
nope.
really don't have any out-of-division rivalries like that. I mean, maybe the Patriots and the Colts at one point were. But it's staggering, and it seems like Derek Carr might be the only guy who realizes that at the moment.
And, Mike, think about this, too. Pretty quick turnaround for Las Vegas. You play on a Monday night. That game on Sunday is a 1 p.m. game.
Yeah.
Advantage Steelers, and their special teams and their defense was great against Buffalo. That's why they got that road win.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.